All right, we're live backstage, callousbackstage.com. I'm Brian Warzel.
I am Bianca Juarez, and we are here with Matt Chandler from the Village Church.
Matt Chandler.
Hey, guys.
You're hot off the Catalyst West Coast stage.
Literally. It was warm.
Like hot.
It was warm.
Was it actually warm up there?
It was really warm up there. Wow. And bright.
Warm and bright.
Yeah.
They brought those lights up so people could read their Bibles.
That's kind of a Catalyst. I need to start putting that in my rider with Catalyst. We got to read the Bible, so can we get the lights up so they can see everybody's like, what's that word? We don't know.
Yeah. You're like, wow, these people don't know their Bible, or
they could quit being selfish and use it on their iPad or their phone.
See, but what I kept thinking is they were afraid to throw the first word out because they didn't know if they had the same version as you.
Oh, that could be it also. But usually even in versions, first words are
pretty much the same.
Yeah.
To each their own, right? But what version do you use?
I use ESV.
Yeah.
I like the word for word, but it's much more readable than, say, like the New American Standard. I used to do New American Standard, loved it, and then I tried to preach to the book of Hebrews. And then I was constantly at the Village. I was constantly going, okay, what he's trying to say here is, see, what these words are really mean here. And I was like, I'm confusing everybody. They're like, I'm too dumb to read my Bible. You know, he can't. It's taken him 30 minutes to explain a sentence to me. So we went to the ESV.
That works.
Yeah, it does.
Well, speaking of the Village Church, what's happening? What are you guys really excited about? What's God doing? And
yeah. Really, it's been a different year for us. We've done some reorganization. You know, we used to hear people say you're not really multi-site until you have three campuses, and we kind of laugh. We're multi-site.
Yeah.
And then we added that third campus, and it really is true. It changes everything.
Death
and so
by third campus.
Yeah, it's pretty nasty.
Okay,
and
for
so,
those who are watching from home and may not know exactly who you are, where Village is,
okay,
a little bit of your background. Let's back it up a little bit. Tell everyone at home a little bit about Village, maybe a little bit of the genesis of where it started, it started, and then we'll go ahead and carry on to where you guys are at now today.
The Village Church was Highland Village First Baptist Church. It was a quasi kind of Willow Creek First Baptist-esque Saddleback thing. I mean, I don't know how else to, you know, how most churches really do, and this is a sad state of things, is they look out there and go, what's working out there? So let's take that and duplicate it here. Instead of praying and seeking and digging into the scriptures and learning best practices, yes and amen to best practices, but to duplicate the Spirit's work here, like to wear a Hawaiian shirt in Dallas.
It just ain't gonna go.
No, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense at all. So now you've taken someone else's hard work and contextualization and you've imported it to your context and it doesn't work. And that was a little bit of what I walked into.
I'm trying to imagine you in a 1995 Rick Warren Hawaiian shirt. Did you have to ever do it?
No.
Did you ever do it, Matt?
No,
Chandler?
I have never. I have no Hawaiian shirts.
All right, look me in the eye.
I have never owned a Hawaiian shirt. I have never worn a Hawaiian shirt. I was a blue t-shirt guy until I got married, and then my wife made me
wives.
Crazy.
Thank you.
Our honeymoon, on a catamaran, she goes, hey, can I ask you a question? So I'm thinking she's going to probe the depths of my heart. Wow. And she goes, how many blue t-shirts do you have? And I was like, gosh, I don't know, 15, 20. Because, you know, when you're doing youth stuff all the time, you got a camp shirt and D-Now shirt, and apparently the couple of years, blue had been really popular.
Yeah.
And so that was kind of my wardrobe.
Upgraded to gray. Thank you to
your
wife,
well,
Lauren.
And it's a polo shirt.
It's a polo?
Yeah.
Yeah. You have
now, I'm not, I can't pull that off. That's just a different, that's a different level, if you will.
Oh, skinny ties are hip in Texas. Don't even try.
I'm not saying they're not. This is just me. Like, I couldn't pull that off.
And it's working.
If I wore that on stage at the Village, no one, they would snicker the entire time. And would not listen to anything I said. They'd be like, what's Chandler doing?
Because
I'm kind of a polo and a jeans guy, and that's just kind of what I wear. So that's.
And it's working.
Yeah,
it's
thank
working
you.
Really
I appreciate
well
that. I feel like we've strayed into this really weird area.
We've strayed way off. Yeah,
because there's. Spinach is about
so
to, like,
I was. I was brought into the Highland Village First Baptist Church by a small group of people hanging on, who really wanted to see the gospel take root there and in that community. And so I was at the time, and this is a part of the story I think it's so important for everybody to know, because they'll go, oh God, grew so fast. But at that time I was preaching at a kind of large singles Bible study in Dallas, about 25 minutes from the Village. And about 68% of that 3,000 had no church home. So when I became the pastor at the Village, tons of them migrated over. And so we were growing by the hundreds almost weekly early on. Well, that creates a lot of political capital. And everybody says, I hate politics. if you are kind to people, when your first thought is, this is what I'd really want to say, but you know, I don't really want to say that. I need to say this because that's what's gracious and that's what's loving and that's what the scriptures would command me to. Then at some level, that's politics. Mm-hmm. At some level, that's you going, I need to do what's right here as opposed to what my flesh wants me to do here.
Okay, so then you do what you feel like God has called you to do, which is right, and then you start like a micro revolution there in the church, which explodes to what?
What the Village Church now is.
So multi-site.
We're multi-site, you know, one church, three locations, I believe is the correct language. Run about 10 to 12,000 on the weekend, depending on the weekend. Pretty young church, although we have been getting older over the last couple of years. I think that's a direct result of prayer and calling certain old people out. Mm. And so, you know, I just always want to go, hey, you can go find, because older people would come to the Village, they'd look around, see all the 20-year-olds, they'd be in their 50s or 60s, 70s, and go, man, this place isn't for us, look how young it is. And so I'd go, look, you can go find a group of 70-year-olds to die with, or you can get in here and help us, right. And here's how you can help us. And it was amazing how just saying that made them go, well, I'll show this young punk, we'll get involved, we'll plug in, we'll, and that was a godsend. I think it's a horrible idea to get a group of 20-year-olds sitting around talking about what they think about life.
Yeah.
And that might be offensive to what some people that are watching, but as a guy that's had to try to pastor through those waters, it's a nightmare because everything feels like this crisis of the moment. So you have your first kid, you're not sleeping, and life's always going to be like that. And that's not true. Mm-hmm. It's not. And so you've got to have people who are older that can go, it gets better. Just breathe. Just survive. This is a survival season. Mm. It gets, and without that kind of wisdom to temper the zeal, then there's always crisis that you have to deal with. And so we were so grateful to get a little bit older, to get some gray hairs, and get like some old people, like 30, 40-year-olds.
For people that want to get more information on what you're teaching and how you're teaching, your theology and all the other stuff, can we drive them to the church website? Is there stuff online, podcasts?
Yeah,
podcasts,
everything we do is free and given away, from videos to, and so they can find that on iTunes. They can find that on thevillage.net. You can go into resources, cultures and theologies. I mean, we try to answer just about all the questions we can answer, position papers that we've written on why we land here, why we don't land here, those kind of things. So,
and just in closing, what ways, if there was like three ways the Catalyst community could join you in the effort to pray and to join those Village Church that love you, your pastor, and to join Lauren and her prayers, what would be like two or three ways we could really just join you in your prayer?
Well, a couple of things on the practical side. I have a 6 more months of chemo, and so that's a week on, 3 weeks off, basically.
How you doing with that?
Some are okay, and some are pretty brutal. And so this I just came out of one 48 hours ago, and it wasn't bad at all. But the one before that, I mean, it just hammered me. And there's no real rhyme or reason to that. There's no, if I do this, it'll be a good round. If I do this, it'll, you know?
Sure.
And so pray for those 6 rounds. I'll be done in August. That's one. Number two would be, in August, we're going to have to make some decisions on ongoing treatment, whether we want to do that or not. Right now, I don't really want to do that. I don't want to keep taking poison when my scans are clear.
Yeah.
But my scans might be clear because I'm taking the poison. So that's kind of, you roll the dice in that. And then overarching themes are, you know, we prayed for healing unapologetically, ask God to heal us, expect God to heal us, trust God to heal us. And if his sovereign will plays out, that wasn't his plan for me, there'll be no bitterness or anger on my heart. But we, like, you know, Adrek, Meshach, and Abednego are going, he can, you know, he can, he will, and even if he doesn't. And so I think join us in praying just that God would, in his mercy, heal us and give us longer time to serve him here, to love my family well, and to be faithful. And then, you know, I want to be faithful in this journey.
Yeah.
Can we put that into practice right now, Brian? Can we just love you, and for those that are watching online, and join us, please, in continued prayer, but even just now, just lifting you up for safety as you travel home, safety for your family, and the things that you had asked for. So, do you mind praying, Brian?
Sure, I'm on spinach. Spinach.
That means you're the meat, bro.
Yeah. Or maybe I'm on. Maybe I'm the mushroom sautéing next to spinach. You know what I'm saying?
I think we've taken this illustration.
We'd love to do that. Yeah. And So, Father, just thank you for Matt and for Lauren and for their commitment to the gospel, for the way that they continue to impact so many young leaders and leaders across the nation, across the world. And God, we're going to continue just to pray for Matt that, Lord, you would hear us. And we know that you do. And so we're just pleading for his total healing, Lord, that you would stand in his body and renew it and redeem it once again, that he might just have long years to love his children, to love Lauren, and to love your church, and to love those that don't yet know how good you really are. So thank you for his life, and we give you glory for it in whatever it is that you choose. But right now, we just stand for his healing, Lord, totally and completely. And we thank you for the gift that he was to us today, just reminding us that we need an appetite for you. God, give us more of that. And I pray that that's what we would see, more of you and less of us. And so we just pray these things in your powerful name, knowing that we can trust you and believe for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.